So at the end of the lecture, the course yesterday, I explained that we were interested in the decomposition of the polynomial xn minus 1 over a finite field fq. And we will always assume that q and n are relatively prime. So q is a power of a prime, n is a positive integer, and the GCD of q and n is 1. And so we look at the polynomial xn minus 1, and we want to decompose it into factors, not only reducible factors, with factors which are in fq of x. And what I explained is that we have a decomposition in the algebraic closure of fq, which is obtained by taking for zeta a primitive nth root of unity in a splitting field or in the algebraic closure. So we fix such zeta, which is algebraic over fq, and a decomposition of xn minus 1 is obtained by taking, so we obtain some factors of xn minus 1 by taking x minus zeta I and the product of a subset I of 1 to n. So we denote it by qi of x, and I is any subset of 1 to n, or 0, 1 up to n minus 1, which means that the number of sets I is 2 to the n. But we are interested in the factors which are in fq. And for that, we have the criterion that this polynomial, a polynomial q of x belongs to fq of x when the coefficients are algebraic over fq. It belongs to fq, so the coefficients are in fq, if and only if q of x to the q is equal to q of x power q. It comes just from the fact that an element is in fq if and only if alpha to the q is equal to alpha. And so this gives this criterion. So we want that this polynomial satisfy this condition. And for that, it's a condition on the set I. And the condition is that if I is in I, we need that qi is in I. But it's not exactly that. We will take I, a subset. In principle, it's a subset of 0 and minus 1. But we will take I as a subset of z over nz. Because zeta to the I makes a sense if I is considered modulo n, since zeta to the n is equal to 1. So what we want is a subset of n over nz, which is stable by q, which means if I is in this set I, then qi is in I. So we will say that this condition means that I is stable under multiplication by q. And so we have like this the set of divisors of xn minus 1 which are in fq of x. There is a bijective map between the divisors of xn minus 1 in fq of n, so bijective map, the divisors of xn minus 1 in fq of fx, and the set I in Z over NZ, which are stable under multiplication by Q, which I will denote by Q bracket, the multiplication I dot QI. And this this bijective map is just given if you have a set I, you associate the QI, which is this one. And if you have a divisor, you look at the exponent of zeta, and this gives the set I. And now we will look at some examples, and we will look at some divisors of xn minus 1. So I will ask you, which are the divisors of xn minus 1 that you know? You know many of them. In FQ of x. So you have this polynomial xn minus 1. So I ask you, give me some divisors of xn minus 1. Yes? There are many of them, so there is not a unique answer. Tell me some divisors of xn minus 1. X minus 1. This is one good example. So this will be so x minus 1. I leave the divisors, and then we will see what are the set I which correspond to these divisors. OK, let me well give me other divisors of xn minus 1. Yeah? X plus 1. Okay, so this is a question. Is x plus 1 a divisor of xn minus 1? Is it a divisor? Okay, you see, if you take n equal 1, it's x minus 1. This is not a divisor. If you take n equal 2, you have x squared minus 1, and x plus 1 is a divisor. So when is x plus 1 a divisor of xn minus 1? If n is even. If n is even, then x plus 1 divides xn minus 1. Because it's x2l minus 1, which is xl minus 1 times xl plus 1. OK, so there are many other divisors that you should find. Yes? 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 Very good, yes. So you have xd minus 1 if d divides n. Okay, there are others that that are even simpler. No? Okay, so you did not think to the simplest one. Well, when you have an integer, and if I ask you, what are the divisors of the integers? There are two obvious answers, which are, if you have an integer n, what are two divisors of n? 1 and n. So you have a polynomial. What are two divisors of this polynomial? 1 is a divisor, and another one is xn minus 1. Well, xn minus 1 is a special case of this one. But these are two examples. Now there are other polynomials that you could think of. Xn minus 1, if you look over z of x, how do you decompose it into irreducible factors, xn minus 1? This is the result of yesterday. Oh, yes. Oh, yeah. This is also a good example to give. We have x minus 1. So we can take xn minus 1 divided by x minus 1. So this is another example, xn minus 1 divided by x minus 1, which is 1 plus x plus xn minus 1. OK, so, but there are other divisors. When we have the polynomial xn minus 1, how do you decompose it into irreducible factor of z of x? You don't remember? This was a result The first result of yesterday, xn minus 1, I want to decompose it into a product of irreducible factor of z. Yes? Exactly, yes. So xn minus 1 is a product for d dividing n of id of x. And so we have all the divisors phi d for d dividing n. So one of them is phi n. And a set of others are the phi d for d dividing n. So we have a collection of polynomials. All of them are divisors of xn minus 1. So to these divisors correspond a subset of 1 to n. You see that the degree of QR, the degree of QI is the number of elements of I. So we look at the degree of the polynomial and we know what will be the number of elements of I. So if the divisor say Q equal 1, what is the set I? How many elements are there? It is the degree of Q. What is the degree of Q? The degree of 1, of the polynomial 1. What is the degree? 0. So what is the number of elements of I? It is 0. And what is the set with 0 elements? It is the empty set. So I is the empty set. And you write the product, which is an antiproduct, and it is 1. Now you take Q equal x minus 1. What is the set? So the polynomial Q is x minus 1. What is the set I? There should be how many elements in I? 1, because we have a polynomial of degree 1. So there is one element, and this element is an element of z over nz. What is this element? 1? I heard only 1 as a proposal. Why 1? Okay, so we have to write the polynomial x minus zeta to the I. And we have to find I. Zeta is a primitive root of unity. And zeta to the I should be 1, which means that I should be 0. So the set I is the set 0. Okay, if x plus 1 is, if n is even, then n over 2 is an integer. And we look at the class of n over 2, and we find that I is just, it has one element, because the degree is 1, and this element is the integer, the class of n over 2 modulo n. And it is just that if you take zeta to the n of a 2, zeta is a primitive n root of unity, but n is even, and zeta to the n of a 2 is an element, the square of which is 1, and in fact zeta n of a 2 is minus 1. In the field x square equal 1 has two solutions, 1 and minus 1. Zeta n of a 2 is not 1, so it should be minus 1. Okay, so maybe we go to the next, we will see this one after. We look at xn minus 1. What is the degree? N. What is the number of elements in I? N, it is the degree. And I is a subset of z over nz, so it is the full set. Okay, so if we look at xd minus 1, xd minus 1 is a polynomial which has the roots, which are the d's root of unity. The roots of this polynomial is a cyclic group of order d. So the roots so x to the d minus 1 as the roots, which are the d's roots of unity. And this is a cyclic group of order D. D is the divisor of N. And Z over NZ is a cyclic group of order N. And you know this was already used in the previous lectures. When you have a group cyclic of order N, if D divides N, there is a unique subgroup which has D elements. And so there is a unique subgroup of Z over NZ cyclic of order D, and this is the I. So the cyclic subgroup of Z over NZ of order D. You can write it as a quotient of a subgroup of Z divided by NZ, but in fact, what you can do is to take N over D Z divided by NZ. You take the subgroup generated by N over D, the elements are F order D, D divides N, so N over D is an integer. And so this gives a polynomial of degree D because I has D elements. Okay, so we come to this one, xn minus 1 over x minus 1. This is a polynomial of degree n minus 1. So we take for I a subset of z over nz, and the number of elements is n minus 1. And so you will check that this corresponds to z over nz minus 0. You do not take 0. 0 was the one which occurred to as x minus 1. And you take the complement. X minus 1 corresponds to 0, and this one corresponds to the other ones. It corresponds to the roots of unity, which are not equal to 1. These are the roots of this polynomial. For phi n, you take for I the generators of the cyclic group z over nz. Z over nz has phi of n generators. Phi n of x is the product of x minus zeta I, where I is prime to n. And this corresponds exactly to the elements which have the order n, and this is the irreducible polynomial of phi n over z, but it may be reducible over fq. And for phi d of x, you take the generator of this cyclic group. So n over dz divided by nz, which is a cyclic group of order d, so it has phi of d generators, and this corresponds to phi d. So we are going to use these examples in the theory of error correcting codes, and so I will give some information about the cyclic codes. I do not repeat what you have seen on the general theory of codes, but what I will do is something that you have seen in the course of error correcting codes, but in a rather different way. So I remind you what is a cyclic code. A cyclic code is a subset of FQ to the n. So it's a code of length n with n elements, which has the property that it is fixed under the shift. So it has the property that if you take an element A0, An minus 1 in C, then I will start with the right shift. So An minus 1, A0, A1, up to An minus 2 is also in the code. So we have a map which to an element of fq to the n, so it maps an element of fq to the n to an element of fq to the n, which is, say, x0, xn minus 1, is mapped to xn minus 1, x0, xn minus 2. So this is the shift. I call it T, because the translation in French of shift is translation, with the T. So this is an automorphism of fq to the n as a vector space over fq. And we can iterate this automorphism, and we get T square, which is the shift which starts with x n minus 2, and so on. And if we iterate it several times, n times, we take the identity, which is the unity of the algebra automorphism of fq to the n. And so this is how the polynomial xn minus 1 comes into the picture. The polynomial xn minus 1 is a polynomial which vanishes at t. So we are interested in the code which are invariant under the under the shift t. Okay, so let me see. Ah, yes. I will denote by psi the following map. It is a map which goes from fq to the n to fq of x, which maps a0 an minus 1 to a0 plus a1x plus an minus 1 xn minus 1. And then I consider the map from fq of x divided by xn minus 1. So I just write it here. I divide by the ideal xn minus 1. Why do we do that? It's because if you look at what is the shift starts with an minus 1, and it corresponds to the multiplication by psi. If you look at the shift of a0 an minus 1, so this is this element which is here. If you take the image by psi, so you have to map, you have an minus 1 plus a0x plus an minus 2 xn minus 2, n minus 1. It's a0x to the 1, so an minus 2 xn minus 1. But because of the condition xn equal 1, xn minus 1 equal 1 in this quotient, an minus 1 is the same as an minus 1 times xn. So this is the same as x times psi of a0 an minus 1. Which means that with this map psi, we have psi composed with t is the same as x times psi. So the shift corresponds to the multiplication by x. So we are interested in the code, which means that the elements of the code, the a0, an minus 1, should be stable under the shift. So they should satisfy the condition that the polynomial psi of a0 an minus 1, this polynomial here, should be stable by the multiplication by x. So when we have a cyclic code, when we take an element A0 and n minus 1 in the code, we have the value psi of A0 and n minus 1, which is, so it's a polynomial in fq of x divided by xn minus 1. If we multiply by x, we get another element in the code. We get again an element in the code. So the image of psi, of c by psi, so psi of psi, is a subset of fq of x, which is stable under the multiplication by x. It's a subspace of the FQ vector space. So you have a vector subspace of FQ of X. FQ of X is a vector space, but it's also an algebra, it's a ring. And the vector subspace is stable by the multiplication by X, but also by X squared, by X cubed, and so on. And therefore, in the algebra FQ of X, psi of C is an ideal. Excuse me, I forgot to divide by xn minus 1. It's the quotient. It's an ideal of fq of x divided by xn minus 1. So what are the ideals of a quotient? The ideals of a quotient are the ideal of fq of x which contain xn minus 1. So I will denote this ideal by I. And there is a bijective map between the ideals of I and the ideals of fq of x, which contains the ideal xn minus 1, the quotient of a ring by an ideal xn minus 1. So we have this bijection. But now the ideals of fq of x are principal. And given an ideal of fq of x, there is a unique generator, which is monic. The leading coefficient is 1. So to a cyclic code corresponds a polynomial in fq of x, which is monic, which generates an ideal. But this polynomial Q should contain xn minus 1, which means that the Q is a divisor of xn minus 1. And it's a piece of luck because we just studied the divisors of xn minus 1 over fq of x. So we have a collection, a list of the polynomials Q, and therefore we have a list of the ideal I and the list of the cyclic codes. To each cyclic code, corresponds in a bijective way a divisor of xn minus 1. So there is a bijective map between the codes, the cyclic codes over fq of x of length n. So this is how we started. Then a bijective map with the ideals. So let me say 1, 2, the ideals of fq of x divided by xn minus 1. And we have a third element equivalent, which is the polynomials in q of x, fq of x, which are monic, and such that q divides xn minus 1. And now we have a fourth element which is equivalent, which is the one which I saw before, which is the set of I in Z over NZ, which are stable under multiplication by Q. So this is the four. I in Z over NZ, which is stable under multiplication by Q. What we did there was independent of the choice of primitive root of unity. So the bijective map between 1, 2, and 3 are, as we say, canonical. But when we got the equivalence between 3 and 4, we had to choose a primitive root of unity. So this is no more canonical. Okay, so there is something else which I would like to add to this bijective map, which is the degree of Q, the number of elements of I, and the dimension of I as the FQ vector space, and also the dimension of the cyclic code. So let me start with the I. Let me see that the number of elements is I is R. Then we have seen before that the degree of Q is R. Now Q is a polynomial of degree R, and we look at the FQ vector space, which is generated by Q. So maybe I could write this here. The ideal I So it is an ideal, as I defined here, but it is also the FQ vector space spanned by one by Q, XQ, X square Q, and so on. And so we have to see what is the dimension of this FQ vector space. And because Q has degree R, this vector space, which corresponds to the dimension, okay, maybe I can write it like this. We have FQ of X divided by Xn minus 1. Inside this algebra, we have the ideal which correspond to Q. So Q is a polynomial in FQ of X. So we have Q divided by Xn minus 1. And we have the quotient which correspond to FQ of X divided by Q. Q is a polynomial of degree R. So this is a vector space of dimension R. This is a vector space of dimension n, because we divide by a polynomial of degree n. And since this is the kernel of this map here, it follows that the dimension here is equal to n minus r, which I denote by d. So d is the dimension of I. So d, which is n minus r, is the dimension of r as a Q vector space. And now if you come back at what we did here, we had a bijective map between which was given by this one, and this means that the cyclic code C has dimension D. Okay, so this is what we have for the parameters. So maybe we can look at some special cases that we have seen before. We can look at the divisors Q of xn minus 1, and to each of these divisors we associate a code. So I repeat what we have for xn minus 1. Let me start with the divisor Q equal 1. So for Q equal 1, this is a parameter R. R is equal to 1. And so D is equal, R is 0, excuse me. The degree of Q is 0. R equals 0. So D is equal to N. So we have a linear code of dimension N and length N. This is the trivial code FQ to the N. On the opposite, if you take the polynomial xn minus 1 itself, then the degree is n, so the dimension is 0, and this means that the code is 0. If you remember, this corresponds to I equal empty set, and this corresponds to I equal Z over NZ. So we can give some other examples by taking the polynomial x minus 1, or in general we can, okay, let me take Q equal x minus 1. The degree of Q is 1. So the dimension of the code is n minus 1. And so it's a code of dimension n minus 1 and length n. So this corresponds to the polynomials a0 plus a1x plus anxn, which vanishes at 1. And so it corresponds to a0 plus, say a0 plus an minus 1 equals 0. So this is a parity check code. The elements of the code are the elements of the hyperplane a0 plus an minus 1. On the other hand, if you take q equal xn minus 1 over x minus 1, then you have r equal n minus 1, and you have d equal 1. And so it's a code of dimension 1, and it is the code which is spanned by one non-zero element. So it is a set of multiple, it is a set of elements of the form A0, excuse me, A. So the multiple of 1, 1, 1. A in FQ. So I advise you to look at the other examples which we gave before of the divisors of xn minus 1. But I would like to describe some further example, which is a little bit more involved, which is the case of the Hamming code. And for the Hamming code, of length n and dimension d, we obtain it by taking an integer r. So we take q, which is given. We take an integer r greater than or equal to 1. And we look at q to the r minus 1 divided by q minus 1. And this is what we take for the parameter n. This value is very convenient because you see that this number is 1 plus q to the r minus 1. We have q r minus 1, which is 1, qr is 1 plus n q minus 1. So it's congruent to 1 modulo n. But if you take q to the s, where s is less than r, q to the s is one of these elements, and it is less than n. So because of this specific choice, we deduce that Q has order A in Z over NZ. And therefore, if we take a divisor of phi n of x, an irreducible divisor of phi n of x, of fq, the degree of this irreducible divisor will be q, will be r. And so this is what we are going to take for the polynomial q. We take for q an irreducible divisor of phi n of x over fq. So the degree of q is r. We have the choice. There are several of them. We take a root of q. If zeta is a root of q, zeta is a root of unity. What is the order of zeta as a root of unity? I do not hear. What is the order of zeta as a root of unity? N. Zeta is a root of q. Q is a divisor of phi n of x. Phi n of zeta is equal to zero. So it is a root of unity of order n. And what is the degree of zeta of fq? It's r, yes. This is easier. Zeta is a root of a polynomial which is irreducible and degree r. So the degree of zeta is r. So we can write the irreducible polynomial of zeta of fq. How do we write the irreducible polynomial of zeta of fq? We can write it as x minus zeta. And then we have x minus zeta q, because the Frobenius gives the conjugates. And so on, x minus zeta to the q to the r minus 1. And it's r minus 1 because the degree is r. This is q to the 0. So this is q of x. And you see that this is qi of x, where I is a set of the exponents of q. So I is 1 q q to the r minus 1. It's a subset of z over nz with r element, which is what we expect. We expect to have r elements. So our code, which is associated to this polynomial q, will be a code of dimension n minus r. So d will be n minus r. This, which is I did not write that d is equal to n minus r. This will be the dimension of the code, which is associated to the polynomial q. So q of x is a divisor of phi n, and therefore it is a divisor of xn minus 1. And so we have the ideal q of x, the image of q of x, in fq of x divided by xn minus 1. and the elements of the code, which is associated to this polynomial Q, are the elements such that so C is a subset of FQ to the N, and it is a set of M0 Mn minus 1, Mn minus 1 in FQ to the N, such that M0 plus M1 zeta plus Mn zeta to the N, Mn minus 1 zeta to the N minus 1 is equal to 0. Because we want that the polynomial M0 plus M1x plus Mn minus 1 xn minus 1 vanishes at zeta, which is the condition that this element, M0 Mn minus 1, belongs to the code associated to Q. So this is a vector space of dimension D, which is n minus r. But the elements which are here, when you have zeta to the n minus 1, you can reduce it using the property that zeta to the q to the r is equal to 1. So zeta has degree r, and therefore, if you fix given so we can reduce an element like n0 plus mn minus 1 zeta n minus 1 by looking at the first component. So when we take so given say xr plus 1 up to xn minus 1, so we have n minus 1, we have d elements, which are the last ones. There exists a unique, so these are in FQ, there exists a unique tuple x0 xr minus 1, so that xr zeta to the r plus xr minus n minus 1 zeta n minus 1 can be written as x0 plus x1, I will put a minus sign, x0 plus x1 zeta plus xr minus 1 zeta r minus 1. So if you give these elements xr minus 1 xn minus 1, xr up to xn minus 1, you can complete them in an element x0, x1, xr minus 1, which satisfies this relation, which is exactly to say that x0, xn minus 1 belongs to the code. This means that we have a bijective map when we take the projection on the first the last component, we have a bijective map between C and the FQ to the D. So this gives a map from FQ to the N to FQ to the D, which is a projection on the last component, which gives a bijective map with C. Now, so I repeat that the definition is a set of M0 and N minus 1, so that this sum is equal to 0. Now I will look at the error correcting code, at the correcting code, and see that it is one error correcting. So let us start with an element x0, xn-1, which is in fq to the n. And let me assume that there is an element in the code m0 mn-1 in C, which has distance of x less than or equal to m, to 1. So it may be that this is an element of the code, and otherwise it means that there is just one component which is not the same. So all the mi and xi are the same, but one. So if you look at x0 plus x1 zeta plus xn minus 1 zeta n minus 1, this will be the same as m0 plus m1 zeta plus mn minus 1 zeta n minus 1, apart from maybe one value if there is distance 1. And what is the error? The error is xi minus mi times zeta I. If the distance is at most 1, so there is at most one component which is different, if this component is I, this is what we find. So if there is an element in the code at distance at most 1, we see that the error is given by a multiple of zeta I. But two multiples of zeta I cannot be equal, so this I is unique. If M exists, M is unique. So if, let me call it M underline, if M exists, M is unique. Which means that the Hamming ball, which are centered in the code and which have radius 1, are disjoint. When you have a point, it cannot be in two Hamming ball of radius 1. So the Hamming ball centered at the elements of C and radius 1 are disjoint. And so now let us look at how many points we have in the union of these Hamming balls. How many Hamming balls do we have? Well, as many as elements in the code, which is q to the d. So that q to the d having elements in C. So there are q to the d Hamming balls of radius 1. Each of them, how many elements do they have? So the radius is 1. In each of these Hamming balls, you have the center, which is one element in such a ball. You have the center, which counts for 1. And then we have dimension n, we have a length n, so you have n components. And the error may be at the first, second, or nth component, so we have to count n. And then there is an error because we are at distance exactly 1. We are not in the center because we count the center here. And so the element which is in error is an x, which is in fq, but it is not 0. So it is nq minus 1. So this is the number of elements in each ball. And the balls are disjoint, so the union of the balls the number of elements is q to the d times 1 plus n q minus 1. But this is where the choice of d, n, and r comes into the picture. This turns out to be exactly q to the n because of the choice q to the r minus 1 is equal to n q minus 1. So we have all the elements, the union of the ball is just the set fq to the n, which means that we have a perfect code, and such a code is one error correcting because the Hamming ball of radius 1 are disjoint. Now this code was given as a subset of fq to the n, and it's a subspace of fq to the n which has dimension d, and therefore it is given as the kernel of a linear map from fq to the n to fq to the r. So such a linear map is given by R linear forms, let me say L0, LR minus 1, which are R linearly independent linear forms with coefficients in FQ. And so C is the set of X such that L0 of X and LR minus 1 of X is equal to 0. The map which is here is a surjective map because the codimension of C is R. So this is a surjective map. So the number of values of the tuple L0 LR minus 1, so it takes Q to the R values. So these values, one of them is 0, so which corresponds to the code C, and the other, so one is 0, and the others, they are q to the r minus 1, and q to the r minus 1 is the same as n times q minus 1. So n is the number of components, the length of the code, and q minus 1 is the number of elements which are different from 0. And so this q to the r values will give, for the coefficient which is n, the position of the error, if there is an error, and it will give the value of the error q minus 1. So for x, which is not in the code, when we look at L1 of x, so the n times q minus 1 values, possible values, of this tuple, give the error x minus m of the element m in C, which is at distance 1 of x. So it gives the position and the value of x. Oh, I made a mistake. I thought it was 20. It was 30. Oh, thank you. Okay, so I am just finished.